How to make better decisions with Laura Gorieri. Laura Gorieri, are you able to join?
Yes. Hi. Hello, everyone.
Yeah. Hello, Laura.
Hi.
To have you. A lot of people wants to make better decisions understanding language in insurance. So let's dive a bit how it's possible.
Okay, so thank you for the introduction. Hello everyone, my name is Laura. I work as a data scientist for Expert.ai. Expert.ai is a company that deals with natural language processing and natural language automation. So we try to take language and make it simple and make it something that companies can leverage on. We have tons of insurance customers because insurance use cases are very complex and they need a very robust and refined engine in order to take what's in a document for insurance and make it easy and make it useful. So today we're going to take a look at a use case together, a very simple use case. Then I will be talking briefly about more complex use cases. But my goal today is to show you what our engine can do for your documents and what kind of information we provide our customers with and how you can leverage and build some simple applications with them. So the first thing that I wanted to focus is that with natural language understanding, we try to take something that is unstructured, such as a text, and make it structured. So make your text have all the information and all the essential details that you need. So since we are going to talk about natural language processing, I wanted to do like a quick crash course in NLP, if you are not familiar with the topic. For this, I am using our demo, which you can find at try.expert.ai. This demo is absolutely for free. You don't need a user. You can just start and play with it. So once you put a document in here, for now, let's ignore what kind of document I'm using. Once you put a document in here, you can analyze it, and then you can see the output of our product, which is natural language APIs. So the output of the natural language APIs is here presented through a user interface. But if you click on JSON here, you have the JSON that comes as a response from our service. So here we are looking at the full disambiguation. So this means that for each element of the text, we have retrieved every possible piece of information that we could find. So for example, if we take a look at this element, which is a verb, we know that this verb as a base form to take place, we recognize that it's actually a verb. And we have also some data about the morphology and the type of verb it is. So it's a verb that describes events. Another functionality that we have in our engine is the key elements extraction. So we are able to retrieve some central elements in your document. For example, in the main lemmas, you find the most important words that are present in the text. And just by looking at here, you can kind of understand what type of document I have input in this demo. Because you see some people, such as Adam King, Rebecca Smith, and you also see that we are talking about a car accident and license plate number, etc. So this is exactly what I meant by saying that you take something that is complex and that has data in an unstructured way and you make it structured. Another functionality that we provide is this entities extraction. So in the document, you can find some elements that we call named entity. And for these elements, you want to be able to extract them and you want to be able to normalize them and assign them the correct label. So extraction means that we want, for example, to retrieve every time that Adam King is mentioned in the document. Normalization means that we want to be able to say that the full name is Adam King, even though sometimes it is referred as to Mr. King or even as a who. And then the correct label here is person, and this is the entity class. We have almost 40 entity classes, and they have been developed to help in insurance and finance use cases. So you will see that, for example, we have things like vehicles, and we are able to automatically extract vehicles that we find in a document. For some entities, we are also able to add metadata that you can see in our demo here. Please always remember that whatever you see here in the interface, you can also access it through our natural language APIs response JSON. And in this case, we recognize that we have a geographical area, and we know that geographical elements have some metadata in open sources online. So we are able to go and scan these open sources and tell you, for example, that Devonshire has a particular set of geographical coordinates. It has, for example, a DBpedia page, etc. So we try to tell you everything that we can about the elements in your document. The last thing that I want to get you familiar with is the classification. So classification is when you have a document and you want to retrieve the topics of that document. These topics are organized in taxonomies, and the taxonomy works as a lens. So when you choose a taxonomy, you choose what kind of perspective you want to have on a document. Here we see the media topics taxonomy, which is a very rich taxonomy about news articles, basically. But it's so rich that it's almost a universal taxonomy. So you can input any text, and the media topics classifier will give you useful information about it. Okay, so once again, this was just to get you more familiar with the jargon that we're going to use from now on. If you want to know more, if you want to play with it, please go to try.expert.ai and you can just start playing with it. The second thing that I want to show you is our developer portal. So in the demo here in try.expert.ai, you can use from interface, you can put text, but it's just, you know, it's just from there. Whilst if you needed to use our natural language APIs programmatically, you will need to have a user in, and you can make one on our developer portal. So the developer portal is developer.expert.ai. All these links are really easy to remember. Once you go here, you can create your user. I already have mine, so I can just jump in. And you will see the dashboard and how many characters you have left for that month. So the free user gets 10 million characters per month. So this is more than enough if you need to test it out and to see if it works for your use cases. And also here in developer natural language API, you can see the documentation for the APIs. And under specification, there's a section that helps you build your first call. So if you want, you can start from here. You can take a look at how to form a correct call, what you need to put as a server, what kind of parameters you need for each functionality that you ask, and so on. Then once you are sure that what you're writing is correct, and you can see the response here, then you can start working programmatically with our APIs. To do so, you have two options. You either just call the service through REST APIs, or you can use one of the two SDKs that we provide. For the demo, we will be using the Python SDK in a Jupyter notebook, So we will use Python method and functions, but keep in mind that underneath it, of course, there's the calls to our APIs. Okay, so let's go back to our notebook and take a look at what we can do with natural language API. So we have seen that our engine helps in taking the complexity of the text and making it simpler. And I would argue that for insurance, this is fundamental. So insurance companies tend to have documents that contain text, and in that text, there are important details. But as I said, it is the details are presented in an unstructured data. So you cannot just leverage on that natively by looking at the document, but you need a natural language understanding engine to process it. And for example, then you have back people, companies, location, other entities, and you can leverage on them. So let's see, for example, what we can do by building a simple application. So what I'm going to show you here, you can make the exact same application on your computer, okay? Because I'm going to use my credentials, but as I said, they are free up to 10 million documents, 10 million characters, sorry. So we are going to take a look at the claim document, which is this one here. The content is not really that important. What I want to show you is that this is a typical document that any insurance company would have an abundance of, I think, in their databases. So we have someone that writes on behalf of someone else, asking for a compensation after a car accident. Then we have a brief description of the accident, of the people involved, and then here we have like a time description of what happened and who hit the car of other people, etc. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do, since we have a PDF, is to convert this document to a TXT. I'm using another Python library, which is PDF Miner, but there are tons of utilities you can use to convert from PDF to text. And now in document, we have the TXT of our claim document. So the first question that we want to answer about this document using our natural language APIs is what happened. So can we know more about what kind of document this is, what it's describing? For this task, we need to use a classification engine. So as said before, we provide a set of classification taxonomies that we can just use, and they are just ready to use. You need no training data whatsoever. So first you import your, in my case, since I'm using the Python SDK, import the library, the Python library. Then you set the API credentials, so the ones that you made on the developer portal. Then you initialize the client, and basically now you're ready to go. What you need next, of course, is to put the right parameters for your call. And in this case, we are calling the classification functionality. For this functionality, we need to say which kind of taxonomy we want to classify on. And we are using IPTC Media Topics Taxonomy. The language of our document, which is English. And the last thing, of course, is we need to pass the document to our APIs. After doing this call, we have this output, which is the JSON response that is then passed and organized into a Python object. So it's a little bit more easy for us to use it in Python. And here we can scan through our output and retrieve all the topics that we found and the percentages. This is important because not all topics are equal. So some of them will be more important or more present than other topics. And we can measure this by looking at the scores or by looking at the percentages of our categories. This information comes out of the natural language API. So I'm using just this. And here we have our output, which is not that nice to look at because it's just a print of two arrays. But what we can do is we can plot this output using in Matplotlib, which is what I'm using right now, to give us a quick overview of the topics that we were able to find in the document. Here, from a practical point of view, for example, what we can do once we have this is we can send this document to the department that deals with road accident and incident, okay? Because we have recognized that this is about a car accident. Or maybe we have like a folder with a bunch of documents and we want to organize all of them in subfolders, and classification can help you with this as well. Another question that we want to answer by looking at this document is who is involved in the car accident. So here we use named entity recognition that will be fundamental to find people that are involved in the accident, and then to link each person to their attributes, such as what kind of car they were driving, or who is the insurance company that insured them, and things like that. To do so, I've prepared just a bunch of very simple functions that look for vehicles, insurance companies, and license plate. And please focus that, please notice that I'm using our named entity recognition capabilities because I'm looking for certain entity classes. So for example, for the vehicles, I don't need to describe how a vehicle is usually written in a document because the engine automatically recognizes them and puts this label here, VCL. Same goes for insurance companies or companies in general. I don't need to describe how a company is usually found and written in a text because I can leverage on the assignation of this company entity class here. For the plate, we don't have an entity class ready, but we can just use a regex. So this is a typical case for regexes. So we'll try to describe how a license plate would be written. So it's a collection basically of uppercase letters, numbers, and then uppercase letters once again. And then moving here, so the functions that we have seen are just helping us, but the core of the investigation is in this script here. So once again, we use our natural language APIs. We have the credentials that we set before, and also the document and the language are already set because we defined them as parameters before. Please notice that we are changing the functionalities that we call. So here we are asking for the full analysis, which is the disambiguation, which is the analysis that gives us everything that we were able to find for each element of the text. Once we have that, we can do a bunch of investigation. In this case, as said, we want to try to discover what people are involved. So once again, we rely on named entity recognition for the recognition of people. And once we find a person, then we try to find its associated vehicle or their associated insurance and associated plate. At the end of this, we were able to find that in our document, we have a mention of two people that possess all these features that we have seen. And here we populated a list. Once again, not the best way to visualize your data. So what I did is I just printed the list in a table fashion with headers, etc. To help you visualize what information we have, and also help you see that this, even if it seems basic for a human, it's not trivial to automate. And once you have this, once again, from a practical standpoint, for example, you can have, for example, all the documents in which we found Adam King, you can save this information in your database, and then you can search, for example, for his name and find all the documents in which he is mentioned. So maybe other claims or his insured policy, etc. And for each of them, we also have a bunch of information, pieces of information that we could link to them, okay? So this, even if it looks simple, it's actually already pretty powerful because for a human, this looks like, well, I just read the text and I just catch this information. But for a computer, for an algorithm to do this automatically, it's not that easy. And this is, I think, yet great value added to an application. Okay, the third question that we want to answer is where did this happen? So we have from our first question, what happened? We know that we are talking about a car accident. Then we know which people were involved in the car accident. And then we want to know where did this accident happen? So to answer this question, we rely once again on our named entity recognition functionality. So we are going to retrieve addresses and geographical entities. They are two different things. So an address is a road and then the number of the building, while whilst the geographical entities is something that has to do with administration. So for example, London is a geographical entity, but it's not an address, of course. And then here I have two functions that just help me clean the output that we will see in a minute. But just keep in mind that once again, I am looking for some specific type of information, so addresses and geographical entities, and I can just, as I did before, ask for the full analysis and then scan through each element of the text until I find exactly what I need. So in this case, we look at elements in the text that have the lemma accident, crash, or collision. So we use this as an anchor. And then once we have that, we find the related address and the related city. Okay, so here we find the address and the city that we were able to link to the place of the accident. Then for the city, we also retrieve latitude and longitude. Please notice that I'm not using a third-party library here. So latitude and longitude, exactly as we have seen in the try.expert.ai, are metadata added to, in this case, a city or a town. So we are able to say that the city of the accident is Exeter, and we are also able to retrieve the coordinates that come from the natural language API. And then we have the exact address where the accident happened. This address here, I want you, you people to focus on two things. The first is that we have the city also in the address. So we were able to recognize it as a city, but also as a part of the address. And the second thing is that our address is in a certain fashion. So we have the number, then comment, then the name of the road, and then the city. This is because we want to give you the address as complete as possible. We want to give you all the information that you need to actually use this address here. And I can prove this to you guys by just using, in this case, we are using Mapbox that helps us when dealing with coordinates and locations, similarly to what Google Maps does, basically. So I'm retrieving the exact coordinates for the address, and then I can show them on the map like this. Okay, so the address that we got, this one here, is already in a fashion that you can just use it, and it points, as you can see, it points to a real place. So in this case, this kind of piece of information could be useful, for example, if you want to pass this document to the nearest headquarters of your insurance company. You have the address and you can find the nearest one that can take care of this. So this was just to give you like a brief introduction in natural language processing and what you can do with our product, which is Natural Language API. You can access this by having a user on the developer portal, and you can start using it today. So as said, this is completely for free up until 10 million characters. So you can do all the tests that you need. And then if you need something in production, you can talk with us and we can see what kind of billing plan we can do for you. I wanted also to show you a brief presentation. Then you have it. So what we have seen so far is a very simple use case, is what you can do from day one using our technology. But of course, insurance challenges can be much more complicated than this. We have been working extensively with insurance companies, so we know very well how complex things can get. And what we have noticed is that insurance companies tend to have a huge collection of documents in which we find unstructured data. So the information is there somewhere, but it's not that easy to retrieve it. And what what do companies tend to do is that they tend to ask people, to ask humans, to read through policies, claims, etc., and then retrieve the nuggets of information needed. This results for us in a missed opportunities from our point of view, because you can automate many of those tasks, and then you can be faster and you can have people do jobs that are more complex and in which they can really give, you know, their input. So this is just some use cases that we have been dealing with in expert.ai. And we were able to automate tasks such as underwriting, risk engineering, claims management, and contract comparison, and a bunch of other tasks. So for example, for risk engineering, we can go through a risk report and then retrieve each risk factor. And we are also able to give you a pre-assigned grade of how well each risk factor is managed by the company that you want to insure. And then you can have like a human that can review this. So instead of reading through the whole risk report, the human can read like a recap or a version which you have highlighted the most important pieces of information, and then take a decision based on that. This results in a series of benefits, of course, for insurance companies. The most important one is that you have a faster processing time. So the automation is up every second, day and night. And this, of course, results in more efficiency and more money saved, and usually also in a better customer satisfaction. If you want to know more about this, please visit expert.ai/solutions/insurance to have more details on this. And thank you guys for the attention. So if you have questions, please, I'm open to answer them.
Yes, Laura, we reached the time all allocated even for questions, but actually you answered the question because most of them were about the use cases. So that you, in your last slides, you actually answered it.